may not be negotiating on the same level or with the same amounts of money as the sharks are, you can still structure the same types of deals with $500 or $1,000 or $5,000 or $10,000. Start where you are and use what you have, but you better make it work. Hello, visionaries. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Maresa Talbert, and I'm the founder and CEO of Talbert Law Office, your favorite go-to legal resource for all things business, nonprofit, and intellectual property law. So before I took my unexpected hiatus, I had a series of videos related to intellectual property and its role as an asset to and for its owners. Some of those videos have discussed topics like whether to sell or lease your IP rights, how to get those IP rights back if you sold them and you regret it, or how to use your IP as a collateral for a business loan. So today I want to circle back to the IP related content and talk about how to structure your royalty payments if you in fact decide to lease, aka license, your intellectual property as an asset. Just to quickly recap, a license is just like being a landlord for a rental property. You own the property, but you allow someone else to pay you for using the property. With a physical property, you'd collect rent, and with intellectual property, you collect a royalty. Those royalty structures can take on many different forms, but today we're going to talk about six different ways that you can structure your royalty payments. So, as we always say, let's jump right into it. Number one is a lump sum. That's as straightforward as it gets. You get one fixed payment for the use of your intellectual property. But we're not talking about selling your IP. You still retain ownership, but you're just allowing someone else to use your property for a certain amount of time. And that lump sum covers use for that time period. Lump sum only payment structures are starting to phase out, as most of the licensing agreements that I've worked on or have seen have some sort of long-term recurring type of payment structure. Or there's a bit of a combination with a lump sum payment in addition to one of the other types of payment structures that we'll talk about later on in this video. All right, number two is a fixed monthly payment. Here are one of the ways that you can create passive income. I think we generally all understand the concept of monthly payments. We all have bills that come due every month like clockwork. And the same can be said for a royalty payment. If you license out your IP for 12 months, then you collect 12 months of royalty payments. All right, moving right along. Number three is a fixed percentage. This percentage is typically based on the gross or net revenue of total sales. For example, if you create a character that is used in a comic book series, then maybe you structure your royalty payment to receive 5% of all comic books sold that include that character. So if the comic book generates $100,000 in revenue, your 5% royalty would equal to $5,000. On the other hand, there is the variable or the tiered percentage option. It's still based on the gross or the net revenue of total sales. However, percentages are smaller when sales are low, and then they increase as the sales start to rise. An example of this type of structure is when one person may agree to pay 5% for the first $100,000 in sales, and then maybe 8% for the next $500,000 in sales. Does that make sense? All right, number five. This payment structure is called a per unit royalty. This payment reflects a rate based on per unit sold as opposed to gross or net revenue. It is often combined with an upfront lump sum payment. So an example could be that you wrote the lyrics to a song and you've negotiated a $15,000 lump sum for the lyrics and then maybe 50 cents on every song that is streamed on any streaming platform. I want you to take a look at these clips from Shark Tank. I want you to hear how these deals are structured so you can get a feel of how these payment structures are being combined in a multitude of ways. Take a look.
Listen, I like this mat a lot. I think it's the best mat I've ever seen, and I've gone through a lot of them.
Thank you.
This one's fantastic.
Thank you.
I'm going to make you an offer now.
Thank you.
Because you guys are so, so newbie. I'm going to give you $100,000, but I'd like 15%. But I would like $1 back per unit sold until I recoup my $100,000. We will blow this up. I'm worth it.
Because we'd love to partner. Because again, we're still growing for the future, and we have a lot
of
runway.
Did I hear the word royalty?
Actually, no. I don't think you said it.
Yeah, I thought I heard royalty.
Yeah. I don't think you said royalty at all. Actually.
I don't know where that came from.
It says young king. Young a king is royalty. That's what it is. Young king, royalty.
Yes.
You know what I like about this? It has sales.
Yeah.
A lot of us, and when there's sales, sometimes my hair starts to grow back. Because it can support a royalty. My favorite structure, as you know, you have the margins. I would give you the $225,000 for a dollar askew until I get back the $225,000, and then it drops to 50 cents in perpetuity.
Kevin, that's enormous.
What you're saying is, this is forever. So when Kay has kids, kids will be paying.
I don't have any equity, so why would I do it any other way?
Kay is sounding like he's going to be working for Mr. Wonderful.
Right.
Kay's not enough for that.
He's only four.
I'm the only shark that believes in you.
I just don't know that makes sense for us.
I love you guys. All right, I know you're not going to do that deal. I'll give you an offer.
Okay.
I think royalties are tough because someone's going to buy you.
Yeah.
But I'll do it for 50 cents until I get a 2x return on the money I give you. So I'm going to give you $225,000. When you pay me back $450,000, the royalty stops. I want a 5% equity that converts if the company gets sold. So I help you now, and if you grow, I convert to 5%.
You know what? That's going to be much more expensive than my royalty. If you sell this business one day.
It's much more expensive.
If you sell this business one day for $500 million, you pay way more to him.
You know what? If you sell the business for $500 million, you don't care.
I like that deal.
That's
a huge mistake. Yeah. This is the balance between equity and royalties. It's a great lesson.
Ain't this good, y'all? Y'all better be out here making deals. You better learn how to negotiate. Or get yourself someone who does, okay?
Here's an offer for you. I'm known for being creative with my offers. I teach the sharks how to structure things. So $350,000, I give you that. Because you brought up the word royalty, I didn't, you did. I like royalties because that's how I get my capital back. So I'll give you $350,000. I want a $3 royalty on the Vabroom until I recoup $700,000. So I'm not being greedy about this, okay? I just want some return of capital. But I want 2.5% of the design firm because I don't know what else is coming down the pipe.
All
right? So equity is sort of a venture debt deal in a way with a structure that I get paid back.
It's actually not bad for
you. It's not a bad deal at all.
So the concept of Shark Tank is a little bit of a different concept of just licensing your IP because they are looking for investors. But the concept of royalties still applies, and you can see how they love royalties even in the deals that they're structuring. And while you may not be negotiating on the same level or with the same amounts of money as the sharks are, you can still structure the same types of deals with $500 or $1,000 or $5,000 or $10,000. Start where you are and use what you have, but you better make it work. Last but not least, there is metered pricing. And this is premised on the more you use, the more you pay. You'll typically see this kind of payment structure when it comes to royalties related to natural resources. So if you're a landowner who leases your parcels of land for the production of oil and gas, this payment structure may make the most sense for you. Or if you live near a body of water and you have riparian rights and people pay you to access that body of water, again, this may make the most sense for you. You see how you can combine two or even three different types of payment structures in one deal? It's important to know that so that you don't feel stifled in negotiating different types of arrangements, or that you don't feel pressured into accepting just one type of structure that may not really work for you. All right, well, that's all, folks. I hope this information was helpful to you as you continue to create and to leverage your creative genius to build passive income. I look forward to reading your comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with a friend. As always, this is Talbert Law Office, your favorite go-to legal resource for all things business, nonprofit, and intellectual property law. I'll see you in the next video. I'ma keep it pushing, yeah.